Dear participants, it is a great pleasure to speak at the New Economy Forum 2019. Innovation is the primary driver of development. The history of human civilization is a history of exploration and innovation, driven by curiosity about the unknown and desire for a better life. We the human race, have been exploring the world and trying to innovate. Thanks to this process, we have made ourselves wiser and enriched our souls. This is what has enabled humanity to embrace reason, build up civilizations, and become one global community. From living like wild animals and slash and burn agriculture to information revolution and smart manufacturing, the humankind has come a long way. Today we possess an ability to create material wealth never seen before. From keeping record by trying knots and using birds to send urgent messages to the advent of airplanes, high-speed rail and 5G network, the world has never been so connected as it is today. From self-sufficiency and bartering goods to the free flow of resources and products by land, by sea and by air, international commerce and trade is flourishing like never before. From isolation, exclusion, and skepticism to mutual understanding, inclusiveness, and mutual appreciation, coexistence, exchanges, and mutual learning of civilizations has become the order of the day. From taking endlessly from Mother Nature to advancing climate governance, environmental protection, and green development, interdependence and harmony between human and nature has become a widely accepted concept. Human progress never follows a linear course, but zigzags as it moves forward. In today's world, humanity still faces many common threats: natural disasters, disease, energy, food, and environmental crises, to name just a few, both in traditional and non-traditional domains. The rapid advances in science and technology, fast transformation of industries, and unprecedented rate of innovation have created a double-edged sword, the impact of which is difficult to assess. Uneven and inadequate development is a growing challenge. Social divisions are widening. Traditional norms and institutions are being questioned. Protectionism, unilateralism, and populism are rising. Economic globalization is facing headwinds. The international order is under attack. History has proven over and over again that when dealing with difficulties and challenges, only the reform-minded and the innovative can forge ahead and prevail. Only innovation and reform can take us through the many challenges we face without losing the initiative. In this global village, we must read the trend of our times and make informed and sensible decisions for our own shared future. Dear participants, history is the present that has passed, and the present will become history in the future. Reviewing the past can tell us plenty about our future. Chinese civilization values both tradition and harmony and innovation and diversity. Around 2,500 years ago, the contention of 100 schools of thoughts enlightened the Chinese nation. Over the long course of history, different ethnic groups came together on this land to become what we call the Chinese nation today, and created a history of glory and splendor. By preserving our heritage, by being open and inclusive, and by learning from others, China has never stopped renewing itself and integrating itself into the world. Historically, China had its glorious days by being open and inclusive and reaching out to the world, but also episodes of hardship and suffering due to self-isolation and closing his own doors. In those days, countless unyielding patriots, waking up to the ugly reality of backwardness and humiliation, embarked on a painstaking search for a path toward China's rejuvenation. Ever since its founding, the Communist Party of China has adapted the basic tenets of Marxism to Chinese realities and combined them with the fine elements of traditional Chinese culture. The party has led the people of all ethnic groups in China toward great achievements by taking a path uncharted before. By creatively using rural areas to encircle the cities and seizing state power with military force, we secured the victory in China's revolution and founded the People's Republic. We have built from scratch a rather independent, full-fledged industrial and economic system through our own hard work. Following the principle of crossing the river by feeling the stones, we have deepened reform and opened our market step by step. We have transformed the planned economy through market reforms toward a market economy. After piloting with special economic zones, we have rolled out the opening up measures nationwide, and now we are championing the Belt and Road Initiative. Gone are the days of scarcity and shortage. Our people will all soon be able to enjoy initial prosperity. China has embarked on a path of socialism with Chinese characteristics that suits us well. Chinese people's revolution, nation building and reform under the leadership of the CPC is an ongoing process of exploration and innovation. It is about keeping to the right direction regardless of what may come its way and correcting its course amid frustrations and setbacks. Practice is the source of theory. It is through our decades-long practice that Chinese communists have adapted Marxism to the Chinese context and enriched and carried forward Marxism through Mao Zedong thought, Deng Xiaoping theory, the theory of three represents, the scientific outlook on development, and Xi Jinping thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for a new era. A new era calls for a new spirit, new thinking, and new action. We will uphold and improve the system of socialism with Chinese characteristics and modernize China's system and capacity for governance so as to translate the strength of our system into more effective and efficient governance. We will continue to combine the basic system of socialism with Chinese characteristics, with the market economy through innovative ways, where the market plays a decisive role in resource allocation and the government plays its role more effectively. We hope to achieve a dynamic equilibrium between survival and development and between fairness and efficiency. We will fully implement the new development philosophy, work faster to modernize our economy, and work toward a transition from rapid growth to high-quality development. We will firmly uphold the CPC's leadership. We will maintain the party's advanced nature and purity, and improve and develop the system of the party's leadership to show that the party's leadership is truly the foundational element of socialism with Chinese characteristics and a major source of our system's strength. If we look around the world, modernization has never been a smooth journey for any country or nation, just like the growing pains that human beings experience. Yet reaching maturity doesn't mean a carefree life either. In the new era, China needs to sustain its prosperity and build itself into a strong country. We are still faced with complex and serious challenges, both at home and abroad. We Chinese people know very well what we have, what we want, and what it takes. Every step we take will be proactive, but also calm and steady. We will keep in mind both the immediate and long-term interests, attend to both partial details and larger picture, and take into account both what's necessary and what's possible. Standing firm on the path we have chosen for ourselves, we have the confidence, patience, and resolve to realize our goal of great national rejuvenation. Ladies and gentlemen, today's China is at a new starting point. Our path of development is a peaceful one. This is not an empty slogan and still less an expediency. The reason why China chose this path lies in its history and reality. More importantly, it is a firm commitment China has made to the future of humanity. The people of China hope to join hands with people of the world to foster a community with a shared future, take on global challenges together, and live up to our shared responsibility of bringing about a peaceful, prosperous, and beautiful world. Together, we can find new solutions to the world's governance deficit. The international system underpinned by the United Nations remains as important as ever. We must hold on to the principles that have long guided us when dealing with new issues and look for new ways to address long-standing problems. We must improve global governance by calling for extensive consultation, joint contribution and benefits for all, promote multilateralism and more democratic international relations, and work for a fairer and more equitable system of global governance. Together, we can find new solutions to the world's trust deficit. Only when there is understanding can there be trust. And trust is essential to making cooperation possible. To understand each other is an ongoing process which consists of not just knowing each other's present, but also knowing each other's history. Better understanding can be gained through books and the media, and more effectively through dialogue and cooperation. Equality, candor, dialogue, mutual accommodation, these are the key ingredients to the spirit that can get different people to respect, to trust, and to agree with one another. A strong sense of responsibility is also important. We must each keep our own house in order instead of blaming others for our own problems. Together, we can find new solutions to the world's peace deficit. Between war and peace, there is no doubt that we should choose peace. This is the choice of the people of China and indeed the choice of all peace-loving nations. We should pursue common, comprehensive, cooperative, and sustainable security, and reject zero-sum game and the Cold War mentality. Dialogue, cooperation, and development, this is the answer we seek to bring lasting peace to our world through common efforts. Together, we can find new solutions to the world's development deficit. The lack of balance and adequacy in development can only be addressed through more development. Development is of fundamental importance. To promote development, we need more innovation, more robust growth models, more coordination, more openness and win-win cooperation. Development must be balanced and inclusive. We need to work together to make economic globalization work for all people across the world. Ladies and gentlemen, as we meet here for the second edition of the New Economy Forum, all eyes are on us now. Present here are all visionary leaders in your respective fields with substantial influence on the global community. I do hope and believe that the sharing of wisdom and exchange of ideas in the next 2 days will produce great solutions that are needed for leading the world towards a new economy and a new future. I wish the forum a complete success. Thank you.